Somebody had asked me some time ago about doing the pile rib on the Brother machines. Well, I tried it with the punch card, and it will not work with the punch cards because when you work with the Brother machines and you set your carriage to KC, it brings the needles out. Where with the Singer Studio machines, it doesn't bring them out. It does as you're knitting, but it doesn't bring them out before. And I found a little way of dealing with this. Now, on the Stinger machines, it tells you to cast on with your zigzag, and then you're going to drop the stitches off the ribber. Well, I've tried that a few times. Unless you work up a couple rows of normal zigzag, one by one rib or full needle rib, it's not going to work. If you want this to start out right in the beginning, then I suggest do your zigzag cast on, two tubular rows, one zigzag to close up that hem or the cast on. But now bring the stitches from the ribber and put them to the knitter. Now, if you have the transfer carriage, it'll probably work. Mine is buried someplace, so I'm just using my 7-prong transfer tool to transfer 7 stitches at a time. And then the last one is 2 stitches, only because that's how I have it set up. You're going to leave the ribber needles in work here. Next, you're going to push in your left tuck button on the K carriage, and you're going to put the right PRN lever up to PR. So now I knit across one row, and it tucked on the knitter bed, but it also put the loops on the ribber needles. I want to hold down these stitches because there's nothing holding them down, and I'm going to use a knitting needle, although it is starting to bend, so I'm going to have to find something else. So I'm just going to hold the needle, and this is a number 3, I believe. Yep. So you want to get a needle that's going to go between the beds here, or a rod that's going to go between the beds, and then you're going to. You don't want the point getting in the middle of the carriage when the needles come out. You just want to go along with the work. So it'll do that zigzag row. Now, what I want to do is remove the ribber carriage, because I need to release the stitches off the ribber carriage. Now here, I'm going to take that same needle, and I should have something with a bend in it. I really don't have anything that will work. But as I go across, I move the carriage, and you can see the needles are coming up, but I'm holding the stitches down. So now it releases those stitches. I take my needle and I push the stitches down to make sure they're not on the hooks. I move the ribber carriage back. It's on slip anyways. And that's all you do. You just continue those 3 steps. I think it's 3 steps. You knit across once. You take a rod so that as you're going across, you're holding the work down because there's nothing, and you'll see it when you try this. Even though I have the ribber comb on, it's still not enough to hold those down. And then I put the needle back, move the ribber carriage across. So it releases those stitches. Just take the point of the needle, push it down, and the loops go down. So So you can do that as long as you need. And as mentioned before, I did try this with a punch card. You have to have it set up just right, but when the needles are out, let me go across again. This would be where the machine will select needles out. And you can't get the needle underneath the hand needle or the rod you have underneath those stitches. Maybe there's another way of doing this, like if you have a thin wire, or maybe I could use ravel cord, but then I have to go thread it between the two beds, hold it down underneath so I can knit across and it'll knit the ribber stitches. I really don't see no way around this, but if anybody else finds a way of doing this, please let me know and I'll try to show it again. So let me work up some more rows of this and show you the end and result. And like I said, this is going to end up being the full bed of having these loops. So I noticed my circular needle hanging on the lamp here. It has a nice little bend to it already. And this is a number one needle, US needle. And I found this to work out a little bit better. So if I could find a rod that's about this thick and put a bend in it, if it's longer, but I could use this for now. So I knit across. I take and I put the bend, so it's my fingers right there on the bend. And I could hold that down and go across, and it pushes the stitches down, so the ribber needles are going to grab that. Now when I go backwards, I do the same thing, but with my left hand. And then I take the point of this, and it goes down between the beds. So it's going to push the stitches down between the beds. But here, I have three that did not go, so I put those needles up. I take the needle to close the latches, and I bring the needles down. There's another one right here. I have to make sure those are lined up. There's another one right there. Maybe it was five that didn't go through. So I could see when I go across with this needle, oh, and there's another one, if the loops had actually gone down or not. But like I said, make sure you put these ribbon needles back up to work. And continue for as long as you need. So here's a close-up of me holding the needle. I'm getting ready to push the ribber carriage across, but I take and put the needle down. As the ribber goes across, the needles come up. And then I take the same needle and just go along between the two beds to make sure that the stitches did drop off of the ribber needles. If not, fix them before I go on to the next row. And there you go. Now this is really kind of hard to see because it is dark color, but up top here is full needle rib, and right here is the pile rib. I could see this being really nice on a scarf.